Uladzislau Smiahlikau. Top ahead of his first world championship appearance. AIBA, of course, is our referee. I've just been informed that the man from Belarus, despite the problems of use in both his first and second name, actually Wasike, Smiahlikau. He's standing as V's. And Monica, the man from Belarus, first from his quarter-final appearance in the Tokyo Olympic Games. It took a boxer as talented as David Maika of New Zealand to prevent him making it through to the medal podium in Tokyo earlier this summer. And he's also been in action with a Belarusian soldier in the World Military Games in Moscow, where it was another quarter-final finish, and the national champion of Belarus competing here on the global stage once again. It has been a very busy summer for him. And in the blue corner, Joshua Wasike from Nairobi. So many of the Kenyan team is actually a policeman in the Kenyan capital. And this, the biggest tournament of his career, bar none. Most of his appearances have been in his homeland of Kenya. He's competed outside of Kenya, but again, never outside the continent of Africa. Oh, 29-year-old. This man has been a really accomplished operator. You can see it's a tall order, both literally and physically, literally and metaphorically, for Wasike. Looking for it, right uppercut was the man in red, Smiahlikau. Didn't quite find the range. That was a good left hand landed by Wasike. Spearing right hand on a downward trajectory. And Smiahlikau. Right hand around the corner during that trade off was landed by Wasike. He then scored to the left hand to the body before his hit with a right hook. And Smiahlikau. That uppercut was a flashing shot. Smiahlikau was on the ropes. A bright start, having conceded the opening round for Wasike, who's come out full of aggressive intent. A loud uppercut again, serving as an effective deterrent. That's not a record. We're going to work with his lead right hand. He really is looking to get inside the long reach, perhaps to inside the jersey of his taller opponent, Wasike. And he does get there, while looking to work away to the body there. Right hook at mid-range, landed by Smiahlikau. Right into the body, threatened to stray low. That's a beautifully picked right cross, and the same shot once again from Smiahlikau. The same chin as Wasike, because the man didn't even blink. Look at so many boxers who are renowned for having great chins in the history of the sport of boxing. They were often possessed. Neck that resembles that of Wasike. Real asset as a shock absorber. The Olympic bronze medalist Evander Holyfield comes to mind. Traps and necks on that guy, my goodness. With the corner post and anti-spots with the main upright. And CK, well, he's been touched up a couple of times with right crosses here, and hasn't been overly troubled. So inside the final minute of this second round, CK continuing to press. Working away to the body, that's from Amika. That's a nice old hand through the guard. And boxing the right, and he switched it up to score with a left jab. Oh, what a right uppercut! That is a beautifully picked punch by Smiahlikau. And you talked about the thickness of Wasike's neck. It was extended by another couple of inches there by the precision and power of that perfectly placed right uppercut. Terrifically picked punch, closing seconds of the second round. Looking for the same shot once again. It did land, but it was altogether more glancing. And the two men engaging a little bit of afters at the sound of the bell. First round unanimously with Smiahlikau. A cracking uppercut. Wasike did well to remain upright. And look at that, such as the margin of dominance in that second round. 4-10-8 scorecards return. Wasike is going to need a stoppage if he hopes to progress in this middleweight preliminary round. Wasike really did go for it, and putting himself in the pocket, just provided the opportunity for Smiahlikau to score with that punch. Pick up the close right uppercut, bring about a standing count. So to the final round then. Trying to chop down the taller opponent in front of him. First time competing outside his continent. No seeding, no rankings in effect. Trying to stretch, the boxer has accomplished. It's now Smiahlikau giving a bow in the first preliminary round. 48 boxers making up the 92 kilogram heavyweight division. So once you get beyond the round of 32, as many as 8 seeds would have been available. 8 seeding spots would have been available if seeds were an option. But with no ranking tournaments to compare the weight divisions against, there's another cracking right hand sends Wasike to the canvas, and it was almost a delayed reaction as the shot crashed home on a downward trajectory. I'm not sure the man's recovered. The referee optimally placed. She's taking a close look into his eyes and she's happy for it to continue. Just beyond the midpoint of the third and final round, and I think Wasike is still on shaky ground here. Not quite sure his legs are beneath him or his senses are fully recovered. And Smiahlikau sensed that as well. He scores with a lead left hook, looking for the right uppercut. It's dipped the knees of his opponent in blue once again. He held on to his man, and I think that's what's kept him upright. Minute to go in the third and final round. Wasike looking into the eyes of the referee. He may be looking to her for some assistance here. But of course, he's going to continue to compete with everything that he's got left within him. I'm just not sure how much he has left, because each shot having an increasingly pronounced effect, the man struggling to hold his boxing stance. His corner might want to look at proffering the towel, but of course, being a member of the Kenyan hit squad, they may be reluctant to toss the towel in, such is the proud tradition that they bring to AIBA style boxing. But of course, safety and the health of the boxer must be paramount. But Wasike hasn't recovered from that difficult period in the round where he was sent to the canvas on a delayed reaction, and in every success that Smiahlikau has been enjoying since that time is having an increasingly pronounced effect on his boxing stance. He appears to have recovered somewhat, testament to his outstanding conditioning, because he's been hit with some heavy, accurate punches from the Tokyo Olympic quarterfinalist Uladzislau Smiahlikau, with a dominant display to open his account here at Belgrade 2021. Second appearance on the World Championship stage. Moving to the one that he had in Hamburg 4 years ago. So a very good performance indeed. For the 28-year-old. And again, his confidence must be sky high after the run of successes that he's enjoyed. Successes in terms of making it deep into the Olympic Games heavyweight tournament. Here's the verdict that should see him progress. And there is confirmation. So, Wasike Smiahlikau prevailing on a wide unanimous point decision verdict.